based on the concepts what we discussed so far. Problems. First problem is find the maximum effective area of a lambda by 2 wire dipole operating at 30 megahertz. How much power is received with an incident plane wave of strength 2 millivolt per meter. So this is the problem. Solution to this problem is, first of all, write down what is the given thing. So it is a lambda by 2 dipole. It is a lambda by 2 dipole operating at 30 megahertz. So F is equal to 30 megahertz. How much power is received with an incident wave, plane wave of strength 2 millivolt per meter? So E is given 2 millivolt per meter. So these are the given things. So what are the unknown things? What we have to calculate? Effective aperture, one. And the next one is power received. Power received. So try to relate the unknown things in terms of known things. We know that A is equal to, effective aperture is equal to lambda square by 4 pi into directive gain. So here directive gain is not given. But we know that already we discussed what is the directive gain dg of a lambda by 2 of a dipole. So that is greater than 1, that is equal to 1.64. That's why it is better to remember the directive gains of some standard antennas. Hertzian dipole already we discussed, and lambda Hertzian dipole is 1.5 directive gain. Similarly, directive gain of lambda by 2 dipole is 1.64. Suppose 90% they will mention in the question itself. So if they don't mention, you have to consider the directive gain of a lambda by 2 dipole as 1.64. So this is the maximum directive gain, 1.64. Here they are asking what is the maximum effective area. So AE maximum is equal to lambda square by 4 pi into directive gain maximum. So the maximum directive gain is 1.64 for a lambda by 2 dipole. So this is equal to lambda square by 4 pi into dg, 1.64. But lambda is equal to c by f, that is equal to 3 into 10 power 8 meter per second by f is given 30 megahertz. 30 into 10 power 6, so this is nothing but 10 meters. So substitute the values. So if you substitute lambda value also, this is lambda square 100 by 4 pi into 1.64. If you calculate, you will get 13.05 meter square. Since it is a area, the unit is meter square. So this is effective aperture. So next, what we have to calculate? Power received. Power received. So we know that power, how we can define effective aperture? Effective aperture is, we can also define as power received by average power. Power received by average power implies power received is equal to effective aperture into power average. So effective aperture already we calculated. Power average, that is equal to effective aperture into E square by 2 eta. Average power is E square by 2 eta. So E is given 2 millivolt per meter. So if you calculate therefore power received is equal to effective aperture 13.05 into E square 2 millivolts, so 2 into 10 power minus 3 whole square by 2 into 125 or 3777, whatever it may be. So this will give approximately 71.62 nano, or approximately this is 70 nanowatts. Therefore power received is equal to 70 nanowatts, effective aperture is 13.05 meter square. So this is the solution to the given question. So this type of questions are very important. Here it is there is a link between the first one and the second one. So to calculate power received, we have to know what is the effective aperture. So this type of questions are important. Next problem is, a transmitting and receiving antennas are separated by a distance 200 lambda, separated by a distance 200 lambda, and have a directive gain, and have a directive gains of 25 and 18 dB respectively. If 5 milliwatt of power is to be received, what is the minimum transmitted power needed? So this is the question. This is a straightforward question. The solution to this is, so the transmitting antenna and the receiving antenna, this is a transmitting and this is receiving, antennas are separated by distance. This is 200 lambda. Directive gains are DZT is equal to 25 dB, DZR is equal to 18 dB. So minimum power to be received is 5 milliwatt. If 5 milliwatt of power is to be received, then what is the minimum transmitted power needed? That is, PT is equal to how much? Here directly we can substitute Friis transmission formula. What is Friis transmission formula? According to Friis transmission formula, power received is equal to DZT into DZR by into lambda by 4 pi R whole square into power transmitted. So here first of all convert, since this directive gains are given in terms of dB, first convert into normal values. So DZT is equal to 25 dB. So 25 is equal to 10 log base 10 DZT. DZT implies, DZT, if you simplify this, you will get 316.23. Similarly, 18 is equal to 10 log base 10 DZR implies DZR is equal to 63.1. So first convert into normal values, then directly here the substitution, nothing else, directly substitution, because we need PT. So substitute all the values, therefore PT is equal to PR into 4 pi R by lambda whole square into 1 by dgt into dgr. So everything is given. Everything is given, just substitute all the values and calculate Pt. So the minimum power needed is, you will get as 1.583 watts. So this is a very simple and straightforward question. So the only thing is, here we have to keep in mind the Friis transmission equation. Next problem is, a transmission line is feeding 1 watt of power to a horn antenna having a gain of 10 dB. The antenna is matched to the transmission line. The total power radiated by the horn antenna. Into the free space. Is option A 10 watts, option B 1 watt, option C 0.1 watt, option D 0.01 watt. So the solution to this problem is, here a transmission line is there, it is feeding 1 watt of power to a horn antenna. This is a horn antenna, suppose, having a gain of G is equal to 10 dB. The antenna is matched to the transmission line, so it is perfectly matching. So the power input to the antenna is, nothing but power feeding by transmission line. Therefore, input power is equal to 1 watt. Input power of the antenna is 1 watt, since matching, because of matching of the transmission line to antenna. Now they are asking, what is the radiated power? Power radiated is equal to how much? Gain in dB. Gain in dB is equal to 10 log gain normal value base 10. So it is given 10 dB. So 10 is equal to 10 log implies gain is equal to 10. Gain is equal to 10. Since gain is equal to 10, gain is defined as power radiated by power in, implies power radiated is equal to gain into power in. So 10 into 1, that is equal to 10 watt. So the power, total power radiated is 10 watt. So option A is correct. Next problem is, consider a lossless antenna with a directive gain of 6 dB. If 1 milliwatt power is 32.8, the total power radiated by the antenna is, the total power radiated by the antenna is option A 4 milliwatt, option B 1 milliwatt, option C 7 milliwatt, option D 1/4 milliwatt. So the solution to this question is, it's very simple problem. Here it is given directive gain is equal to 6 dB. Directive gain is equal to 6 dB. Lossless antenna. So lossless antenna means efficiency is equal to 100%. Efficiency is equal to 100%. We know that power gain is equal to power radiated by power in. Here but it is given directive gain. Since it is a lossless antenna, for a lossless antenna DG is equal to gain, that is directive gain is equal to power gain. Directive gain, this is a directive gain for a lossless antenna, both are equal. Directive gain is equal to power gain. Therefore what happens, DG is equal to 6 dB, so DG is equal to 6 dB. So if you convert 10 log DG base 10 is equal to 6, implies if you calculate DG is equal to 4. DG is equal to 4. Therefore the total power radiated is equal to, this is also equal to power gain G. So P in into 4, that is 4 into 1 milliwatt, that is 4 milliwatt. Therefore the total power radiated is 4 milliwatt. So option A is correct. So here no need to confuse, since it is a lossless antenna, since lossless, the total power radiated is equal to power input. So don't consider like that. If you consider like that, the answer is 1 milliwatt. Since it is here, it is given a directive gain of 6 dB. For a lossless antenna, directive gain is equal to gain of the antenna, power gain of the antenna. So if you calculate, you will get 4 milliwatt. So option A is correct for this question. Next problem is, number 5, an antenna in free space receives 2 microwatt of power. 2 microwatt of power when the incident electric field is 20 millivolt per meter. The effective 20 millivolt per meter RMS, in the bracket RMS, this is a RMS value. This is RMS value. The effective aperture of the antenna is, the effective aperture, the effective aperture of the antenna is option A 0.005 meter square, option B 0.05 meter square, option C 1.885 meter square, option D 3.77 meter square. The solution to this problem is, first of all write down what is the given parameters. So here in antenna in free space receives 2 microwatt of power. So power received is 2 microwatt. Then the incident electric field is, so incident electric field is E is equal to 20 millivolt per meter RMS value. This is a RMS value. This is a RMS value. So convert to normal value. So if you convert to normal value means E RMS is equal to, E RMS value is equal to E by root 2. Therefore normal value is equal to root 2 into E RMS. So that is equal to root 2 into 20 into 10 power minus 3 volt per meter. Then they are asking what is the effective aperture AE. So effective aperture AE, we know that power received by, how we can define effective aperture? Effective aperture is equal to receiving power R by average power of the incident. So therefore we have to calculate effective aperture itself. So that is equal to power received by PR by power average. So how we can calculate average power? Average power is E square by 2 eta. E square by 2 eta. So that is equal to power received into 2 eta by E square. Therefore if you calculate, A is equal to power received is 2 into 10 power minus 6 watts into 2 into 120 pi, because it is a free space. So impedance is 125 ohms, E square. So E square is nothing but root 2 into 20 into 10 power minus 3 whole square. So if you calculate this, you will get 1.885 meter square. 1.885 meter square. So the answer is option C. Option C is correct. Option C is correct. So here everything is directly given. So just to relate unknown things in terms of known things, then you can solve the problem very easily.